In this video, I'm going to teach you and explain to you how you can get rid of your dog's leash aggression. All that and more coming up. Hello, dog lover. My name is Saro. I'm a dog trainer, also coach dog owners. If this is your first time, welcome. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will get notified as soon as I post my next video. In this video, I'm going to explain to you how you can help your dog to get over their leash aggression. I'm not going to show you before and after a dog who has a leash aggression because that is not realistic. We can't get rid of this behavior by one video or within a week or 2 weeks or a few months. It takes a long time to get over this issue of leash aggression, which I'm going to explain, and you're going to understand why is it that way. Most dog trainers, what they do, they film a before and after of a dog who has leash aggression. So they film the before, which the dog is aggressive and reactive, and then exercise the dog physically and mentally and emotionally. They drain the dog to the point that the dog doesn't have the energy to react anymore in that session, where they misguide you to believe that this dog is done, is trained, and the behavior is gone. The behavior is still there, so it is not realistic for me to show you a video of a before and after of a dog who has leash aggression in a form that is not only true, but also is going to misguide you, which is not fair. So as I said, once you learn why this behavior happens and how you can address it, then it's all going to make sense. So let's get started to understanding why this happened. And also at the end, I'm going to share with you what techniques and ideas or solutions you can use to help your dog to get over this behavior. So there are a few reasons why dogs become leash aggressive. I'm going to address three of them. Number one reason why dogs get aggressive, especially leash aggressive, is because they're lacking social skills. You may or may not have intended to socialize your puppy or your dog when it was young, but maybe you didn't socialize it properly, or maybe you got a dog who had bad experience when it was puppy. So when the puppy is young, there is an age that a puppy should be socialized with everything, with dogs and humans and everything else. If you miss this window of opportunity, this is one of the results that we get. We get a dog who is leash aggressive because the puppy didn't get the opportunity to practice social skills properly. So you may say that my puppy was social, it was doing well and everything, and all of a sudden something happened, or I have been doing a good job of socializing my puppy and my dog overall. Then why is this happening? 4 out of 5 dogs, the reason this happens is because they're not socialized properly. One, because you missed window of opportunity to socialize your puppy, and two, probably you didn't socialize, or the puppy didn't get socialized properly. Something or someone did the wrong way, and this is the results. Now, I always mention to my dog lovers that don't focus on the negativity. Don't focus on this. Don't focus on the past. Now is now, and we're going to focus on now and the future. But this is one of the reasons why dogs have leash aggression. Now, number two reason, and this is again a very important reason and very important point that you have to understand and accept, is because your dog or your puppy is stressed. There are many reasons again which can cause your dog to become stressed. Maybe lack of exercise, maybe too much exercise, even lack of social skills can cause a dog to become stressed. Maybe even the food that you're feeding your dog can cause stress in your dog. If you want to learn more about stress, I have made a video that I'm going to link it over here. You can go ahead and watch that. But stress is one of the main reasons why dogs have leash aggression. Stress causes them to become anxious and stressful and start panicking and react. And that reaction, it turns and translates to leash aggression. Could be even, for example, the leash itself can become a source of stress to your dog. It's not that your dog is leash aggressive because you attach the leash, it's because you're limiting your dog to the leash. It can be causing your dog to become stressed because it doesn't know how to deal with this situation, doesn't know how to solve this problem, so it becomes more and more stressful. Now, the third reason why your dog is leash aggressive is because it's not focused on the main thing that it needs to be focused, which is you. A dog who's leash aggressive are either spoiled and given too much freedom, and there's no structure in their lives. So when you provide a lot of choices to a dog, that also causes them to get stressed. And when you allow a dog to have many choices, they will pick a lot of these bad choices and they will focus on those. So what I mean by that, for example, if you're walking your dog and your dog has the option of focusing on other objects or other things or other dogs or people rather than you, there are so many things that they can focus on. They can focus on cars, they can focus on dogs, they can choose humans, they can choose squirrels. There are so many things that they can focus on. And when you allow a dog to focus on so many things, it causes them stress. That's because structure-wise, they haven't learned to focus on you. And that's because you haven't focus trained them. Focus training is allowing the dog to learn strictly from you, by you, and learn exactly what they're supposed to do. You should be the guidance to your dog. You should be the source of information for your dog. The reason your dog is leash aggressive is because it's lacking information. You are not giving good information, or you're not giving information at the right time, or you haven't been giving information to your dog. Therefore, your dog is stressed and is confused and is lacking all those social skills and stressors and is involved with all these choices that it needs to make. All these becomes reasons for your dog to be leash aggressive. So it has nothing to do with using a tool to fix this problem, using treats to fix this problem, using force or domination or intimidate the dog to listen to you. This is because your dog is mentally unbalanced, so therefore it behaves this way. So what can you do to help your dog to get over the leash aggression? The easiest and simplest formula that I can share with you is my formula of providing your dog's daily five essential needs, which are exercise, training, socialization, care, and affection. If you provide these five things with your dog, for your dog, every day, for the next 2, 3, 4 months, even 6 months, if you stick to it and you practice and work on these, you will have a dog who's not going to be leash aggressive. This is the formula to fix the leash aggression. It takes few months to get results, but if you do it properly, you will get results. So for the short term, 3 months, for the long term, 6 months, your focus should be focusing on providing these five essential needs for your dog. So if you want to learn more about five essential needs of your dog, you can either watch the following videos that I'm going to link it here, or you can join my online course that I have the link in the description below. Just know that there are solutions. There are ways to get rid of this behavior. And force or food or domination is not the way to do it. All you have to do is understand the deeper reason why your dog is behaving that way and help your dog to overcome it. Food, tools, or domination or force are band-aid solutions. They don't heal the real cause of the problem. They only solve the problem for now. And that is the reason I won't show you before and after video of a dog. Because if I start working on one dog who has leash aggression, it's going to take months, maybe even years to get results. Because we have to get rid of all that input from the dog and then override all those negative information with new information, which is this formula, and then we may see results. If you have any questions, leave those questions in the comments area. And if you want to learn more and become an educated dog lover, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also join my online courses that I have the links provided in the description area. And until next time, have fun with your dog.